Hello dear students, in business law we are going to discuss a very important topic, that is conditions and warranties. When seller is selling goods to the buyer, some important rules and conditions, so that has to be mentioned to the buyer, and buyer is also must know what are the rules and regulations, how is the condition and all these things. So this description, we call it as a stipulation. Stipulations, we can say stipulation means it's a description of the goods, conditions, how is the condition, is there any repair is required, like you would like to know anything related to this, that we call it as a stipulations. So the rules and regulations are important terms and conditions. So out of the stipulations, important conditions, very important, which cannot be avoided, that we call it as a conditions. Conditions means very important, it cannot be avoided, conditions. Now second one, which is not much important, so that is warranties. Terms and conditions which are important, which cannot be avoided, that is conditions. Warranties, not much important. If any contract, in any contract, if any sale is there, so out of that sale, very important concepts are very important rules, so which we cannot avoid, so that kind of qualities which is not fulfilling by the seller, then it can be repudiated. Repudiated means reject. New word in law you can learn, repudiate. Repudiate means reject. If the contract which is not fulfilling conditions, in such cases the buyer can repudiate or reject the contract because conditions are not fulfilled. And another side is warranties. So these warranties are not fulfilled, just because of warranties the buyer cannot repudiate, the buyer cannot reject that. So that is the difference between conditions and warranties. So conditions are important, warranties are not much important. If conditions are not fulfilled, buyer can reject, buyer can repudiate the contract. If warranties are not repudiated, so for that buyer can claim damages, but he cannot repudiate, he cannot reject the contract. So this is by conditions and warranties. Now what is the stipulations? Important rules, important conditions, so that we are discussing. Now related to these conditions and warranties, we are going to discuss only the implied conditions as per law. Very important topic, implied conditions. So implied means must. Unless these qualities, these rules or these conditions are not applied, a contract cannot become a contract. Straightforward, the buyer can reject the contract. So what are the rules and regulations of these conditions, implied conditions as per the rules? So this is discussed in the sections 14 to 17. 14 to 17, implied rules and regulations are discussed. The first one is that implied condition as to title. Implied condition, so title must be clear. Whenever seller is selling the goods, the title must be very clear. If title is not clear, buyer cannot purchase the goods. So this is what saying implied condition as to title. Title must be clear. Now we'll have a case here, Roland versus Dival. In Roland versus Dival case, a person who sold goods is here stolen car, he just sold it. Now purchaser is saying that the title is not clear. How can he expect title? It is already stolen car, no title. So the court of law held that title is not there, it's not a contract because it's a stolen car, theft car. So that is why title is not there, no contract at all. This is implied condition as per the title. Second one is implied condition as to the description. As per the description, it has to be mentioned. Suppose say he described that my car is this, my scooter is this, my asset is this, something he described. According to that it must be. If it is not following, then it can be rejected under the conditions. Condition is not fulfilled because description is something and given something. It has to match. So we'll have a case, Shepherd versus Cain. Shepherd versus Cain. In this case, a person ready to buy a ship on the condition that that vessel, means one part of that ship, is prepared with copper. The moment when he wanted to purchase it, and he observed that copper vessel is changed into steel vessel. That is very important. That is the condition. The condition is not fulfilled. As per the description, it must be copper vessel, but it is now steel vessel. So he rejected it. The court of law also held that the primary object of this condition is not fulfilled. What is the condition? Copper vessel is not there in the ship. Rather than that, steel vessel is arranged. So that is why he can repudiate, he can reject the contract. So a purchaser is having full rights to reject the contract. So this is comes under the description is not fulfilled. The third one is that implied condition as to sample. Whatever sample is given by the seller, same it has to match with the present goods also. Sample is something different and goods are something different. Then in such cases, the purchaser can repudiate or reject the contract. So through a case we'll see. So the case is here, Modi versus Gregson. Modi here, bar owner, and Gregson. So here Gregson has given some sample to the Modi. A sample is beer sample, and he said that this, just observe the sample, same kind of goods I'm going to sell. Sample was good. Then after that, when bulk quantity of beer is transferred to the bar owner, he observed the quality was not good in that, and he sent some goods to the sampling purpose. Later they came to know that in that goods, hair dye color was mixed. Imagine, sample is given is something, and what he received is the original material. What he received is in that hair dye color was mixed. Then he has full rights to repudiate the contract because sample was different and delivered goods is mixed with hair dye. So that is why implied condition as to the sample, whatever sample is given, according to that it has to be, otherwise he can reject, repudiate the contract. And the fourth one is implied condition as to description and sample. Fourth one is, it's a combination of second and third. In second, what we have discussed, description. Third one, sample. Now fourth one is here, description and sample. Whatever is described, it has to fulfill the same. As per the description, it must be, and also as per the sample, both the side it has to fulfill. Then only it will become a condition. Otherwise, if anything is missing, so description is okay, sample is not good. A sample is okay, description is not up to the mark. As per the description, it is not there. Then automatically you can reject. A simple example you take. I want to buy a scooter. And as per the description, title is good and color is this and condition is this. And these are the conditions. Means compulsory, it has to fulfill. Anything is not fulfilled. Color is supposed to say, I expected white, but he has given black. It is a condition is not fulfilled. So description is not there. So like in the same as sample, whatever sample he said, that same sample it has to be. Any differences, it can be repudiated, it can be rejected. So this is fourth point. Next, fifth one is that this is as per the section 15, subsection 2. Next, implied condition as to quality and fitness. Quality and fitness, whatever is described, according to that it has to complete. Now what court of law says is that the seller says a lot. This is this and that and whatever he is supplying. Now ultimately it is the duty of the purchaser. Duty of the purchaser to check the quality and fitness before purchasing, before taking, before handing over. So it is the responsibility of the purchaser to check the quality and fitness. If it is fit, if it is good, then only he can accept it. Anything is missing, then he can say, he can reject it. So that is what we say it as a doctrine of caveat emptor. Doctrine of caveat emptor. This you may get in short questions also. What is this means? It is not, it comes under the implied contract. What it is says, when seller is selling the goods, it is the minimum responsibility of the purchaser to check the quality and fitness. If he is happy, if he is satisfied, then only he can proceed it. Otherwise, no. So what is the meaning of doctrine of caveat emptor? It means buyer beware. Buyer beware. It's your responsibility. You have to take care. So that's it. This is about the implied. So implied and conditions. Now we have discussed what is conditions. Let me give you a recap. Conditions, warranties. The main rules and regulations and conditions, important terms, it has to mention by the seller to the purchaser. That we call it as a stipulation. Stipulation are two types, warranties and conditions. Conditions are important. It cannot be rejected. It cannot be left. Warranties are not much important. But if any loss is there because of warranties are not fulfilled, you can claim the loss. This is conditions and warranty. We have discussed implied conditions. Implied conditions, the implied condition as per the title. Title has to be clear. And implied condition as per the description. As per the description, it has to clear. And implied condition as per the sample, whatever sample is given, according to the sample, the rest of the material also has to match. Implied condition as per the description and sample together. Then implied condition as to quality and fitness. Quality and fitness has to take care by the buyer only. That is why we say it as a doctrine of caveat emptor. Means buyer beware. So this is about conditions and warranties. Am I clear about this topic? Immediately just take any test book and read it and write the notes. Till exams you cannot forget this topic. So in the description I have given a lot of topics. Please watch it, learn it, and do help someone who is struggling to learn the subject. So thank you very much for all your feedback. And I'll be preparing lot more subjects, lot more topics. So till then, please take care and study well, get the good result. Good luck.